हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते। फ्रेंड्स, यू आर वाचिंग दिस इमेज और दिस फोटो ऑन माय प्रेजेंटेशन। दिस इज अ मेडिकल शॉप और फार्मेसी स्टोर फ्रॉम विच वी परचेस डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मेडिसिंस after prescription by doctor. Now these products, this includes tablets, then it includes different types of injectables, for example injections and other injectables. Then that products includes capsules, then different types of cosmetic products here, then other products includes ointment creams, then gels, and finally different types of ophthalmic solutions. So all these products or pharmaceutical products, these are available in the market, and all these pharmaceutical products, they are produced in the different types of pharmaceutical companies or pharmaceutical industries. So these pharma industries, they produces these products, but is there any microbiological test which is performed on these final pharmaceutical products before launching into market, and is that test is essential for these pharmaceutical products? The answer of this question is yes. The particular test is very essential, or it is to be performed on these finished pharmaceutical products, and that test is called as sterility test, or it is known as sterility testing. So this sterility testing, it is the part of quality control, or all these processes, that is production, then these finished products, then quality control, as well as raw material, all these components, these are the part of quality assurance. And this sterility testing, it is the part of this quality control and indirectly of this quality assurance. So our today's topic is sterility testing for pharmaceutical products. So this is the title of our today's video lecture. Myself, Assistant Professor Santosh Napte, Department of Microbiology, Sambhajirao Kendre Mahavidyalaya Jalkot. I welcome all of you in my YouTube channel Microbiology by Santosh Napte. So these are the different videos which are available on this YouTube channel. Totally near about 140 videos on different topics of microbiology. These are already uploaded on this YouTube channel. You can subscribe this YouTube channel and watch all these videos. So friends, don't forget to subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte. Like the videos, share these videos with your friends and students, and also comment on these videos. So without wasting our time, let's start this sterility testing of pharmaceutical products. So in this today's lecture, we will see about what is this sterility testing. Then we will see why it is performed on these finished pharmaceutical products. Then we will see the culture media which are required for this sterility testing. After that, we will see different methods of sterility testing. Then we will see procedure for that each testing method. And then we will see about the interpretation of results. So friends, let's start with this sterility testing of pharmaceutical products. And first we will see what is this sterility testing. So sterility testing, it is the microbiological testing which confirms that the products are free from the presence of any microorganisms. So whatever that finished products are here, which are produced in this pharmaceutical industry, that pharma products must be free from presence of any microorganism. So that's why that quality controllers or microbiologists, they have to perform these sterility testing on that pharmaceutical products. This test, it is designed to demonstrate the presence or absence of viable contaminating microorganisms in pharmaceutical or biological products which are designed for the human use. And this testing, it is very important for medical devices, for different pharmaceutical preparations or products and other materials. So next point is here, why this sterility testing is performed on these finished pharmaceutical products, why it is necessary. This sterility testing of pharmaceutical products, it is required during the sterilization validation process. So whatever that method is used for sterilization of raw material, for example, so whether that process is valid or not, that can be checked by using this sterility testing. Then as per United States Pharmacopoeia, this requirement sterility testing is an official test which determines the suitability of a batch or lot for the treatment of different diseases. Then this sterility testing is useful in designing a validation process and providing of adequate and reliable sterility test data is an important quality assurance issue. So that's why it is very essential to perform these sterility testing on these pharmaceutical products. So the next point is here, culture media which are required for this sterility testing. So this is the first nutrient medium, that is the name of this medium is soybean casein digest medium, or it is called as triptychates soya broth, or in short it is known as TSB. So this medium, it is suitable for the culture of fungi as well as aerobic bacteria. This medium is used for sterility testing by membrane filtration as well as by direct inoculation method. So these are the two methods of sterility testing. One is membrane filtration and another one is direct inoculation. This medium, it is also used as pre-enrichment broth for non-sterile products. Then another nutrient media for the sterility testing is called as fluid thioglycolate medium. So this is the second medium, fluid thioglycolate medium, or in short it is called as FTM. So primarily this fluid thioglycolate medium, it is used for the detection of anaerobic bacteria. These are also used for aerobic bacterial detection. And this medium is also used for sterility testing by membrane filtration or by direct inoculation as described in the United States Pharmacopoeia or European Pharmacopoeia. So another nutrient, that is the culture media which are required for that sterility testing, includes clear thioglycolate medium. So this clear thioglycolate medium, it has the same growth promotion properties as the standard medium which we have seen in previous slide. Then this is an alternative formulation which brings extra visual clarity as compared to the fluid thioglycolate medium, which has a slight turbidity as well as haze. And this, that is clear thioglycolate medium, it has high visual clarity preferred by many users, and it is when compared with slightly turbid appearance of the fluid thioglycolate medium. So the next point is here, that is the methods of sterility testing. So there are two methods are used for the sterility testing of pharmaceutical products. One is membrane filtration method and another one is direct inoculation. So this membrane filtration method involves or includes the filters which are usually made from esters or the mixtures of esters and cellulose having the 0.45 micrometer diameter and 50 millimeter diameter is used. So these are prepared for the sterilized filter assemble, or alternatively it can be cut the filter paper into pieces and then put it in the culture media. The second method is here direct inoculation method. So this method is used for liquid samples, then tenfold dilution is done, and for solid samples 100-fold dilution is done by using a special diluent, and the larger volumes is used for antimicrobial activity elimination. So the incubation period for these both tests is, that is for membrane filtration technique and for direct inoculation method, it is 7 to 14 days. And this longer duration period, it is because of to allow the growth of some slow growing microorganisms or contaminants. So this is the diagram of membrane filtration assembly. Actually, these are not the related to that sterility testing, but when we perform that membrane filtration, so that sample, it is poured from here. Here there is a membrane filter is there, which allows the adhering, or it does not allow the passing of that microorganisms. And here this is the clear fluid here. So later on, that filter pad, it is placed on the nutrient agar or nutrient medium, and these are incubated. So after incubation, such type of growth will be appear here. So this is the membrane filtration diagram. Now the next we will see here, that is actual sterility testing methods. And as we know, the first one is here membrane filtration sterility testing. So in this test, that microorganisms, these are collected on the surface of a 0.45 micron pore size filter, then washing the filters with fluids to remove inhibitory properties which are bacteriostatic or which are fungistatic properties. Then this filter, it is segmented and then transferred to the appropriate media. For example, these filters are transferred to fluid thioglycolate medium which support the growth of anaerobic as well as aerobic microorganisms, and these are also transferred to soybean casein digest medium or SCDM, which support the wide range of aerobic bacteria and fungi including yeast as well as molds. And then that plate is incubated for 7 days. Second method is here direct inoculation of the culture medium. So as per to the United States Pharmacopoeia, who recommends two culture media for this sterility testing by direct inoculation method. One is fluid thioglycolate medium or FTM. This is used for the detection of aerobic as well as anaerobic bacteria. And second one is here triptychase soya broth or TSB, that is fluid soybean casein digest medium. And these are primarily used for the culture of fungi and aerobic bacteria. So the next point is here, that is direct inoculation of the culture medium. Its procedure. So the container is cleaned with suitable antimicrobial agent to remove the previous microorganisms if present, and aseptically opened to avoid further contamination and helps to avoid the false positive result. Then the specified volume of the sample is withdrawn, that is about 1 ml, and aseptically 1/2 is added to the fluid thioglycolate medium and the other half is added to the, that is that second one is added to the triptychase soya broth. Then that fluid thioglycolate medium is incubated at 30 to 35 degrees Celsius, which is the suitable temperature for bacteria or optimum temperature for bacteria, and that Triptychus soya broth, it is incubated at 20 to 25 degrees Celsius temperature, which is the optimum temperature for fungi. Then the incubation time is 14, that is up to 14 days according to the United States Pharmacopoeia, which allows the or which assure the sterility of the product. Then the next point is here, that is interpretation of results. So how that results can be observed? So this is the chart with the help of which you can interpret the results of these sterility testing. So after the incubation or during the incubation period, if growth is not observed on that nutrient plates, then that particular product passes the test of sterility. Means now it can be packed or it will be available to the patients in market. So that preparation is sterile. But if growth is observed, then containers are reserved and retest is performed as in the original test. And after performing that retest, if growth is observed, then microorganisms are isolated and these are identified. And if growth is not observed, that means that product passes the sterility test. So microorganisms are isolated or identified, and if they are not readily distinguishable from those growing in containers reserved in the first test, and if they are readily distinguishable from those growing in containers which are reserved in the first test, then second retest is performed using twice the number of samples. And that preparation here, that preparation fails the test. So if these are not readily distinguishable, that means that preparation or that pharma's products, it fails the sterility test. And second retest is performed using twice the number of sample, then if growth is observed, that means that pharma product again fails the test. And if growth is not observed, then preparation or that pharma product, it passes the test. So this is about the interpretation of results of sterility testing by membrane filtration method and by direct inoculation method. So friends, watch this whole video. If you are not subscribed to this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, kindly subscribe this channel and don't forget to share this video. So next time we will come with another important test which are conducted in pharma industry or other industries. Thank you.